أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم والتابعين إلى يوم الدين، وما بعد. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم ارزقنا علما نافعا ورزقا واسعا وشفاء من كل داء، ونعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع ومن قلب لا يخشع ومن عين لا تدمع ومن نفس لا تشبع ومن دعاء لا يستجاب له. آمين آمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم أتمم علينا نعمك ظاهرة وباطنة، واسترنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك، واجعلنا من الذاكرين، واجعلنا من المسبحين، واجعلنا من المؤمنين، واجعلنا من الموقنين، واجعلنا من المتوكلين، واجعلنا من أهل الثقة والرضا واليقين، واجعلنا من أهل الطاعة، ومن أهل الفلاح، ومن أهل الصلاح، ومن أهل الإصلاح، ومن أهل العزة، ومن أهل المعزة، ومن أهل الهدى والرضا يا رب العالمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، today we continue the topic of the disease of the heart, and in the meantime we will mix it with what's going on and the relationship between disease of the heart and what's going on. If you try to summarize the disease of the heart, the early scholar said, what does the disease do? We talked about it before. He gives you disability of function. For example, your body, you can able to do, you have certain energy. But when you're sick, your energy is diminished. Your ability is diminished. And this not only that, sometimes it diminishes many things inside and do not allow you to do many things you want to do. Similar, the disease of the heart diminishes the vision, the ability to see, the ability to comprehend, the ability to receive guidance, the ability to give. Meaning what? It makes you deny everything. This is why the kufr is a deny. And because the kufr is a deny, similar. Kufr is a deny. And also the disease of the heart is considered a state of kufr. Because you will never have a disease of the heart unless you have certain kufr. I was trying to give you some verses about what's happening today, and I was shocked. The more I look, the more I dig, I find more. To the point, I find Quran containing over 300 verses about ayatullah. Ayah or ayat? What is ayah? What is ayat? Ayah is a singular. Ayat is a plural. Now, what is ayah? Ayah in Arabic, it has many meaning. Ayah can mean a complete sentence. Ayah can mean a garden surrounded with a wall. They call it ayah. If you have a garden and has a wall, this garden with a wall is called ayah. By the way, anything complete and it has a meaning, it can be called ayah. For example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he mentioned ayah, it come in a different meaning completely. The word of Allah is an ayah. The sign of Allah is an ayah. When Zakaria alayhi salam, he get the news Allah tell him, آياتك ألا تكلم الناس. The ayah for you, don't talk to people. Meaning the sign you're going to give it to the people is don't talk. Fast from talking. And do tasbih day and night. But as he said, if you have a sentence, it has a complete meaning and it has a purpose, it's called ayah. This is why in Quran, the verse in Quran called ayah. What make it ayah is a complete. This is why one of the adab, not to stop in an ayah in the middle. Why? Because you're breaking the meaning. By this way, almost like you're stubbing the message. By this way, ayah also is a message. Ayah is a message. But ayah, by the will of Allah, is a complete, comprehensive message. Short or long. Now, I find something amazing in Quran. In chapter al-Nahl, chapter al-Nahl, meaning chapter 16, verse 11, 13, 65, 67, 69, 101, and let me find it. Arad, chapter Arad 13, verse 5, 18, 22, 25. One more, I hope I will find it for you, inshallah. Ar-Rum, chapter Al-Ankabut, chapter 29, verse 24, 49, 50. Chapter Ar-Rum, 30, verse 21, 22, 23. I will explain very soon. Surah Al-An'am, chapter 6, verse 46, 55, 65, 97, 98, 99, 105, 109, 126, 157, 158, Now, what I share with you in here, something amazing, is really amazing. And chapter 26, verse 8, 67, 103, 121, 128, 139, 154, 158, 174, 190, 197. Now, let me tell you what is common about all the verses I give you. It has been repeated in Quran over and over again, but in a different format. And if it's repeated in Quran with different format, meaning called tawqid. Tawqid meaning to emphasize a message. Big time. Meaning this message is big, very big. What happened? All these verses, it end up with the same sentence identical. What it mean? Maybe they will understand this message only to those who believe, only to those who comprehend, only to those who remember, only to those who see, only to those who hear, only to those if they have intellect. And in Surah Al-Shu'ara is the opposite. All the sign of Allah and the majority of people is not a believer. The majority of people do not believe. The majority of people cannot see. The majority of people in a state of heedlessness. The majority of people is denied. The majority of people is busy. The majority of people is not aware about our sign. Now, and in Surah Al-Ra'd, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I give you all this time. And this is for those who believe in my meeting with me. Those sign for those who believe in me. Those sign the one who think. Those sign the one who have intellect. If you remember, how many people claim they have intellect? But intellect in here different than intellect by any, you know, measure. The intellect in here, the intellect belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, take it step by step now. If you have iman, if your iman is alive, if your iman is alive, meaning you have no disease. And if your iman is alive, now you can see, you can comprehend, you can reflect, you can receive. Why? Because you are the believer of the meeting of your Lord. Today, if you ask me something I tell you a long time ago, if you see the sign of Allah is coming and the majority of people in a state of heedlessness. Us, the one who claim we are a Muslim. And we're not aware about it. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to see a sign, he run outside. He cried to Allah and he make ibtihal. What is ibtihal? When he raised his hand all the way up to the sky and he cried and begged Allah and make dua. Today, even if we see the sign, and I tell you, wake up, do something, think about it, because the minimum to be scared inside, to be alert, is many dua about that. When the wind is coming, we do not know if this wind coming carry rahmah, the mercy of Allah, or carry torture. The cloud can carry torture, the cloud can carry rahmah. We do not know. We do not know. We do not know. If we're not sure, it should make us alert. But again, all the verses in Quran about the sign of Allah, this for the believer. What about the disbeliever? What about the unbeliever? Allah promised, and if I give them a sign after sign, it will not make a difference. Even if I send them angel from the sky, and they see the angel coming, it will not do anything except increase their own arrogance and stubbornness. Now, we have to ask ourselves, the storm came, the storm is gone. And by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the storm, it went down in power and strength. By whom? By the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want it to continue, it will make it continue. If you want it to continue with full force, full force. Extra force, extra force. Less force, less force. Why Allah allow it to hit with less force? Meaning still a chance. Is a rahmah and a warning. And this applied to us, individual and collective. For example, diseases is an ayah. Your age is an ayah. Your pain is an ayah. Your old age is an ayah. Why? We're leaving. We're leaving. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the majority of people is not a believer. The majority of people is not thinking about me. The majority of people is not thanking me. And the majority of people is in a state of heedlessness from our side. Now, when I hear this, who am I? And today, I see something scary. We talk. 5 minutes later, is a person in the Lala Land. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was, one of his manner is long, silent, and deep thinking. And he worry a lot. And this is a companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam received too. When you study Abu Darda radiallahu anhu and Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu, what is the famous qualities you have both of them? Long silent, a lot of zikr, a lot of thinking. But let me stop in here for a moment, because today a lot of us is not thinking, a lot of us full of shayateen, and we think we're thinking. Thinking, according to Allah, the thinking of the power of Allah, the thinking of the punishment of Allah, the thinking of the glory of Allah, the thinking of Jahannam, the thinking of Jannah, the thinking of the Day of Judgment, the thinking of the journey of the soul, the thinking of death. This is the thinking. But today, And he tell me, and she tell me, and I tell her, and where I'm going, and what happened. This not thinking, this shayateen. Make you busy. Give you Indian movie, Arabic movie, whatever movie. And make you busy for nothing. Can you achieve nothing? The thinking about Allah, the thinking about the unseen, the thinking about Akhirah, develops the reality of Iman. To the point, it makes you sit and wonder, contemplating, wonder, why I should be asking myself, where am I? Who am I? Where I'm going? What is my ending? Where it will be? How it will be? Who will walk in my janazah? Did I go with the ending of a good ending or a bad ending? Now, all this contemplating and thinking, what it will do? This will generate the real life of Iman. Now, do you think now if you have really a vigilante of Iman, you have jealousy, you have envy, you worry about tomorrow, you worry about provision, you worry about he and she, you worry about your weight, you worry about your look, you worry about provision? No, I'm worried about something high. Because it's many a hadith about that. Whoever busy with Allah, Allah will take care about him. It's a hadith Qudsi. من شغله ذكري وقرآني عن مسألتي أعطيته خير ما أعطي السائلين. Whoever be busy with remember me, thinking about me and my Quran, I will give him better than the one who seek it. And even better than the one who making dua. Imagine. Because what it means, when you study human life, if all of a sudden you forget the food in the oven or in the stove, what it means? Something is higher make you busy than the food. Do you get it? Hopefully, yes. Sometimes we go to the bathroom and we forget. There's a bad sign. It's supposed to be you forget something because you engage in something higher. Supposed to be. And if you are a wacko, forgive me, you go for a lower. Now, supposed to be, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you a message. You forget yourself. You forget what you want. You forget your desire. And you remember me, I give you better. I give you better. Now the storm came, the storm gone, and everybody go back to their life like nothing happened. This is bad. This is bad. Similar to when we read Quran, we read Hadith. I see it all over. It's people reading, people even giving da'wah, but they do not have it. And before you know it, it makes you sick. And you forget the basic. Is this knowledge supposed to be for me? Me, not you. If I don't benefit from it, how I can benefit you? If I don't live the knowledge, how I can give it to you? By this way, we have to ask ourselves a question now. Is me among the people who believe? Is me among the people who believe in meeting the Lord? Is me among the people who have intellect? Is me among the people of thinking? Or the opposite? I'm among the people who do juhud. Meaning what? Deny. Deny with arrogance. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. If you go to internet and find even how many call Muslim making joke over the storm, joke. By this way, the storm becomes generating a joke. It's supposed to be generating fear, warning, or a glad tidings to the believer. And we should say, Allahumma sallim ya Rabb. Sallim ya Rabb. Sallim ya Rabb. Oh Allah, give us peace. And give our ending with salam, with peace. And protect us, ya Allah, from your torture. And this should generate more iman, more awareness, more awakeness, more thanks to Allah, more hope, because I'm still have hope. Allah, give me a chance. I still have time. One sister, she sent me a text message or email, and she asked me, I know you now for many years. I'm listening to you, but I did not change. What's the problem? Meaning you never took the medication. It's big difference between hearing. You can go to the doctor. The doctor give you the disease. He explain it to you. And he give you the cure. And he tell you, take it this way. If you're not going to take it exactly step by step, what will happen? Huh? You will not get a cure. How many times the doctor tell you, don't rush. The medication work in 2 weeks, in 3 weeks. And not only that, the journey. You take the medication, you will be cured. You drop the medication, you get the disease back. What happened if I have a habit to take the medication only once a day or once in a while? I have no system, I have no discipline, I have no obedience of taking the medication. Do you think I can grow? No way. Do you think my disease will be cured? No way. And every time I make an effort, one time, two times, oh, brother, I make an effort. What do you want me to do? I have no change. Excuse me, how long? The companion make an effort 13 years. You're so arrogant and happy about 1 day or 2 day or half a day. We do not have istiqam, steadfast. And imagine when you go to college, imagine you go to college and after 2 days you said, excuse me, I want degree now. Why do not see change? Give me the final exam. Can you? We're so arrogant and we do not see it. So arrogant and we do not see it. Because we're acting like a child. I want what I want now. This is not Islam. We're not running the show. I take the medication and it's up to Allah to benefit me with the medication. In the time He want, in the way He want. And He promised He trial me over and over again to check my sincerity. Now ask yourself, did you follow up for years? Or you follow up for days, or half a day, or a few hours? And when a person is so sick, he go to the hospital. And he will not be released until he's finished. Can you tell him, I feel good? No, no, no. He tell you, not yet, you're still sick. This talk, when you look at the Quran, is no force. What it meaning? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over and over again, He said this sign is not for everybody. For those, again, who believe, who thanking me, who think about me, who remember me, who elevate me, who think about meeting me. But if I'm busy in nonsense, in my helicopter, You think I will get the sign? No. Sign after sign and disease after disease, meaning I'm sick. Because by the way, if you cure, if you pure, if your iman is alive, you remember Allah, you're thanking Allah, you remember the Day of Judgment, you think about Akhirah, you're busy about good deed, you remember, you are engaged in some journey of iman. Now your disease is diminished. It's very minimum. Attack of shaitan will be very minimum. Because what is the ultimate? What is the ultimate of journey of iman? Is la ilaha illallah. You remember one of the famous basic hadith, and very powerful hadith, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, al-imanu bid'un wa sab'una shu'bah. Is some above 70 of a branch. Iman, some scholars said 73, 74, 75, 76. Meaning the branches of iman is 70 and a sum. What Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, a'laha, the highest level of iman. What is that? What is the highest level of iman? La ilaha illallah. Wa adnaha, and the lowest level of iman. If you walk in the street and you see some garbage or something can harm anybody, you take it and you put it aside. This is iman. Today we throw garbage. When I see that, I said, subhanallah. Meaning the lowest level of iman is not there. Imagine during Hajj or Umrah, the Muslim throwing garbage like crazy. And I look at that. How? How you can be a mu'min and have vigilante of iman and you know where you are and you do not make an effort to drop the garbage where it belongs? By this way, instead of cleaning the road, we dirty the road. Now let's focus today about only one topic. A'laha, the highest level of la ilaha illallah. What it mean? What it mean? La, no, no to me, no to my family, no to my whatever, no. No to everything above, except Allah. This talk is easy, very easy. But what it mean? My thinking about Allah, my love is for Allah, my devotion for Allah, my time is for Allah, everything for Allah. If everything for Allah, what will happen? Now I'm living la ilaha illallah. My faith in Allah, my trust with Allah, my tawakkul, rely on Allah. And nothing bother me. No situation is shaking me. But this is a journey. It's a journey. Bless me, my time, my devotion, my feeling, my money, my inspiration, my goal, only to achieve the pleasure of Allah, the love of Allah, the relationship with Allah, to, you know, to help others, to do da'wah, to worship, to do zikr, to do tahmid, to do tasbih. Now, ask yourself in the last 2-3 days, what you busy with? What you thinking about it? What you want to achieve? This will let you realize where's your iman. What happens if you're not stable? Meaning your iman is not intact yet. The journey of iman is not rooted. And those who said, okay, but I meet you, I know you, I heard you for 10 years, for 15 years, big deal. It is your struggle, not you hearing me. A struggle, mujahada. Can I do mujahada in your behalf? Can I? No. Nobody can do mujahada in your behalf. And let me give you bad news. And those who talk like that, if they come to me and ask me advice, I give them advice. And they go implement 5, 10% of the advice, and 90% they throw it away. And they never follow up the advice. And if you follow up the advice, you follow up the advice their way. And after that, they're blaming me. Similar. Allah choosing me to be a human being. Allah choosing me to be a Muslim. Allah give me the medication. And when a situation, astaghfirullah al-azim, we blame Allah. Instead of blaming ourselves. Or we blaming each other. No. No. La ilaha illa anta. سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم اللهم إني أسألك العفو والعافية والمعافاة التامة في الدين والدنيا والآخرة اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا. This is my message inside of me, between me and Allah. And I have to live between the two. The hope of the rahmah of Allah and the fear and the taqwa which prevent me from going in the wrong direction. Both. Now, I want you to reflect. What happened when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gave Bani Israel all the ayat. We want a table with food coming from the sky. Take it. Lift the mountain above us like a cloud. Take it. Allah took the mountain, elevated above their head. And Allah tell about them. And if they see every sign, they deny it. And the opposite. When Allah love you, He give you humble and humility. When you're humble and humility, a lot of people do not get it until now. They think if I walk, this humble and humility. No, this is a lie. Humble and humility, when you're really between you and Allah, remember who you are. And put yourself in the right position. What it meaning? How insignificant am I? And how Allah Jalla Jalalu is. You remember in Surah Nuh, Chapter Nuh, one sheikh, when I was young, he used to make me cry a lot. Really. And every khutbah, he used the same thing. What he did, he used to recite verse 10, Surah Nuh, until verse 14. Four verses. But when he come to verse 13 and 14, he used to cry, screaming and beating the ground. Do you know why? If you read verse 13, 14, Surah Nuh, this was a scenario, a dialogue happened in the time of Nuh alayhi salam, when he advised the people, make istighfar, ask Allah to forgive you. And when you read the two verses before that, what happened to the people of Nuh? They put their finger in their ear. And they put clothes over their head. And said, we cannot hear you. We cannot see you. Meaning, look at the amount of denial. But Allah in the end, He said, they were stubborn. They were stubborn and arrogant. And the resentment against the message. And after that, Nuh alayhi salam explained what happened in verse 8. ثم إني دعوتهم جهارا. And I give them advice loud and clear. ثم إني أعلنت لهم وأسررت لهم إسرارا. And I give them the message loud and clear in a seen and unseen. What it meaning unseen and unseen? Seen meaning I give them dawah. Unseen, he keep making dua for them. And making dua for Allah, to Allah guide. And after that he said, فقلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا. The person who is arrogant and stubborn, he would not even ask Allah for forgiveness. But until now, we do not know what it means. Imagine I did something against you, and I tell you, forgive me. You said, I forgive you. I smack you, and I do it again. Is this meaning, I'm humble to you? Meaning, if you repeat things over and over again, this lack of adab. Similar, you cannot say astaghfirullah al-azim and you continue what you're doing. No. If you want to make istighfar, you stop first what you're doing. You make tawbah first and after that istighfar. And if you do istighfar, it has to be followed by tawbah. But can I do istighfar and tawbah at shaji? Let it go. This is not istighfar, this is not tawbah, it's a lie, it's a hypocrisy. This is not politeness with Allah. And what happened now? He said to them, you make istighfar. يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. Allah, he sent the sky with rain for you. وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بَأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ. And he give you money, and he give you kids. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. And he give you garden. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. And he give you river. مَا لَكُمْ لَا تَرْجُونَ لِلَّهِ وَقَارًا. Read this verse very easy and very carefully. 13:14. Believe me, I'm saying it to you and my body's shivering. And I remember the sheikh. What it mean? He asked him, why you have no respect to Allah? Why you have no dignity to Allah? And imagine if you have no respect and dignity to Allah, what Allah will do? You will never have dignity, you will never have respect. You want to know who you are? You are according to the status between you and Allah. It's not a talk. It's not a talk. It has to be done. But this is internal status, it's not external. Is internal. Basically, you cannot fake it. You see? And when you do that, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala emphasizes it. وَقَدْ خَلَقَكُمْ أَطْوَارًا. And He creates you in a many levels. For example, you are young, you become youth, you get elder, you're going to die. And after that, Allah emphasized the message. أَلَمْ تَرَوْ كَوِفَ خَلَقَ اللَّهُ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ طِبَاقًا. Did you not see the sky? How many levels? وَجَعَلَ الْقَمَرَ فِيهِنَّ نُورًا. And the moon is light. وَجَعَلَ الشَّمْسَ سِرَاجًا. And the sun is the torch. And after that, he continued. But the main concepts in here, number 13. مَا لَكُمْ لَا تَرْجُونَ لِلَّهِ وَقَارًا. Why you do not have respect to Allah? And all this talk will not benefit you unless you engage in dhikrullah. And tasbih, and salah ala nabi, and thinking about akhirah. I cannot do it for you. You can come in here, listen to me until I die, and many sheikh come and many, doesn't matter. It's not how much you listen. It is how much you have humble and humility to what you're listening to. Not to me, to the message of Allah. And the message of Allah require homework. And what's the homework? Action. How many times I used to tell you that? Action. And where's the action coming from? From sincere intention and thought. If your thought is pure, imagine, I said it before and people take it and it's almost like it's not there. Every day you can get married. And every day you can get a palace. And every day you can divorce. And every day you can lose a palace. Palace, not a house, not an apartment, not a piece of land, a palace. And this palace is not here. This palace in Jannah for infinity. Imagine how our iman is weak. I promise you, not me, astaghfirullah al-azim. Allah promise you. You do that, you get palace in Jannah. You do that, you get this. You go do. Imagine just to visit a Muslim sister for Sabilillah. For Sabilillah only, you get a palace in Jannah. You visit a sick person, you get a palace in Jannah. You do this, you get this. You do this, you get that. Whoever start his brother or sister by salam, if I talk to you in a bad manner, and you give me salam first, and you open your heart to me first, you get a palace in Jannah before me. Imagine, I'm a little bit uptight about you. And I said, I'm not going to call her. I'm going to see if she called me. I lost the palace in Jannah. Just like that, I lost the palace in Jannah. Look how stupid we are. For some ego and some whatever, I lost the palace in Jannah. And the opposite. You remember the story with Ali ibn Abi Talib? When he used to delay the salam to Umar radiallahu anhu. And when Umar complained, he said, Ya Rasulullah, Umar Khattab radiallahu anhu. He said, every time Ali ibn Abi Talib meet me, he didn't give me salam. Rasulullah smiled, because he know. He said, Ya Umar, come. I'm sorry, Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ya Ali, come. Why when you meet Umar, you don't give him salam? He said, Ya Rasulullah, I know how much you love Umar. And you said, whoever starts with salam, he get a palace in Jannah. And I'm delaying my salam for Umar to start to get the palace. I want it for him. Look at their thinking. They're thinking completely akhirah. Not me and you. Oh, why she do this? And phone call, and we go for drama. We make salah, we make fasting, we go to halaqat, but we're living Indian movie. Really? We swear by Allah. I'm not going to worship you. I'm going to worship the Indian movie. Ah, I'm Indian. Ah, I'm not a Muslim. Because Islam is a status. Iman is a status reflecting our behavior. And it will never reflect in your behavior unless it reflects in your thinking, in your thought. When you wake up, what do you want? How many of us busy about many miscellaneous today? And we make a bus fast over. And we're spending a lot of time. And it's not a big deal. This lack of iman. And instead of thinking how to gain today, how to get a gain palace today, because today is not coming back. Believe me, I'm hurt. I'm hurt very bad. Very bad inside of me. And I'm trapped. Because every time I try to help people, I'm stuck. I'm stuck. And I'm losing. And instead of gaining, I'm losing. And I beg Allah to guide me, to help me, to give me strength. Right, so as a storm came, is a sign of Allah. Allah waking it up, meaning is a warning. What it meaning? Is a chance for some, warning for some. And the following one will be more severe. More severe. If we're still alive. What about us? What about me and you? What are we planning to do? Meaning I have a chance. It might can be me next. Are we exempt? No. It has nothing to do with where you are. And I gave a talk a couple of days ago. What the difference between the mosquito and the hurricane is no different. It's a sign of Allah. Nobody can stop the qadr of Allah. Nobody. You can do whatever you want. And if something written, it will happen. You remember Sister Zubaydah? She's coming from South. She's stopped in Mumbai airport. She come out of the airport. What she will do? She drink. What kind of drink? What's the name of it? I do not know, remember. Bamburi. And what happened? She go to the hospital. Virus in the liver. Can we sit now? How dare you do that? What happened is done. عند القدر يعمل بصر. When قدر arrive, all the mean will stop. Can you change who you are? Can you change your kids? Can you change your husband? It's an ayah. Can you change your age? Oh, brother, I'm going to eat well. I won't be 15 tomorrow. Go, do your best. Yeah? Can you take some vitamins, some nuclear, whatever? You become 15 tomorrow? Look to the people who do facelift. Every 2-3 months, facelift. Until their face, astaghfir Allah al-Azim. There's no ending. And even if they do facelift, what will happen? They become younger? No way. They will die. Every day we are closer to the grave. Like one scholar said, you know, when a baby arrived to the earth, the moment the baby arrived to the earth, he arrived to the earth with a sentence. A sentence already done. He will die. Finished. Once you arrive, meaning you are alive. Once you are alive, meaning you will die. There's no another way. If you're going to live, meaning you're going to die. And if you're going to die, you're going to be resurrected. This is Islam. And if you're going to be resurrected, Allah wants me to think about my journey. Is anything higher than that? No. This is a calamity. The calamity to forget the real promise of Allah. How many verse about that? A lot. The promise of Allah is true. The promise of Allah is the one who will be fulfilled. And the promise of shaitan is fake, is a lie. Don't listen to him. This topic is very simple. It's basic. It's one of the basic things of our life. But are we living it? What's the difference between the hurricane and our age, our illness? Can we stop the illness? Can we stop aging? What's the difference? Can we stop the weather? Can we choose what we want? Wake up big time. The message is a wake-up call. To do what? To remind us about meeting our Lord. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Think. How many moments in your day you think about akhirah? How many moments in your day you want to achieve akhirah? And how many moments in your day you think about your lunatic, your daily stuff? How many moments you think, I want to achieve today, I want gain today? Believe me, any day I do not achieve something belong to Allah, I feel choked. I feel a loser. Big loser. One day is gone. Imam Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, he said, if shaitan give you tasweef and make you lose today, you will lose tomorrow. And if you gain today, you gain tomorrow. Think, reflect, if we are a believer, are we gaining? Can I say, oh Allah, I'm busy. I have laundry. I have to cook. I have to eat. I have to go to the bathroom. Is this excuse? None of this excuse. And life will continue challenging us. It's a challenge. It's a challenge. The whole life is a challenge. For Allah to challenge our iman. I give to Sarah the beginning of Surah Ar-Rum. Alif Lam Mim. أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. Allah challenging us. Do you think you will call yourself a believer without the trial? And we trial the people before you. For Allah, you know who is truthfulness and who is a liar. Period. By the way, if you hear Brother Ahmed and you do not change, don't blame him. Don't blame nobody. Go to another one, another one, another, it doesn't matter. No sheikh in earth can change you. You have to change yourself. You have to make an effort. And you cannot go to the day of judgment and say, oh Allah, I listened to brother Ahmed, but it doesn't work. What do you want? If I buy baking soda or baking powder, and I make a cake, and the cake will not rise, I get another one, it doesn't work. Another one, it doesn't work. Do you know what happened? It was not the baking powder. It is my technique was wrong. I do not put the right amount in the right time and I do not use it in the right way. What it mean? I was stubborn. I did not follow the consultation and advice and the recipe. I am the one who's wrong. It's not the baking powder. I never forget it. When I start making cake, I keep putting baking powder until I put half a box. And now becomes so sour and it come like rock. I said, what going on? It's not the amount, it's the technique. Oh, I'm listening to Brother Ahmed, but I'm not rising. What do you want me to do? Are you taking the recipe the way it is? No. You're taking the recipe the way you want it. You will never rise. Who's the owner of rising up? Allah. You are with Allah, Allah rise you up. If you stop blaming, complaining, and do, once and for all. Time is running. Time is running. Tomorrow is not coming back. Is not coming back. Every chance in the past is gone, is a past. Every opportunity of good deed is gone, is gone. Sometimes it choke me when I see each other. We're not really, really running after good deed. We're running after everything except good deed. This is a bad sign. By the way, it's a sign of Iman. You want to get closer to Allah. You want to remember Allah. You want to thank Allah. You want to read Quran. You want to do zikr. You want to do good deed. You want anything to please Allah. And don't blame. Don't complain. And once Qadr is arrived, لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. And the qadr of Allah is always khair, always good, always good. Is your illness is bad? What about accident? Why I get an accident? Why I get food poisoning? Can I say, why hurricane? Go, 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 go. Can you save yourself from hurricane? No way. Can you save yourself from death? Can you go to the pharmacy, get a death antidote? Did you ever heard about it? If you take this pill, you'll never die. I swear by Allah, the one I'm going to meet him. Two people, supposed to be a Muslim. One was Jordanian, and one was Egyptian. And both of them, shaitan really get them. The Jordanian man was the son of a multimillionaire. And he go to people who do black magic, voodoo, sihr. Do you know why? He said, I hate to be sick. And he go with the intention, he want them to make sihr for him, by this way he will not get sick. And he said, I do not want to die. I said, are you crazy? Look how shaitan, and all his life running from one sahar to another, he paying all his money, million and million of dollars, just so somebody give him a recipe, by this way he will not get sick and he will not get dead. I said, you already did. You already did. Because if you believe you're not going to die, something wrong with you. I was wanting to get a gun or something and hit him in the head and tell him, you see, you're dead. But it's not worth it. And another one, every time I meet him, I don't want to get sick, I don't want to. I said, excuse me, you cannot say that. The qadr of Allah will take place, will take place. You eat well, you do not eat well, you eat organic, you do not eat organic. Ya Allah, where is iman and yaqeen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Yes, we take care about ourselves, but the qadr will take place, will take place. If you study even bugs, two people can be in the same bed. I have a husband, wife, one time call me and tell me, we have a problem. I said, what's the problem? She said, I get bit all over, and my husband sleep like nothing happened. What I do? I said, excuse me, what do you want me to do? The bugs love you. Because the bugs, they love certain blood. And they do not like certain blood. By the way, her husband is sleeping and she gets bit all over. And she complains about the husband. This is amazing, really. She gets bit all over. And her husband, not even one bit at all. Next to each other in the same bed. And the bed and the whole bedroom is infected. Was bug big and what is it? A bug? Bit bug or bug big? Which one? What you call it? Bug bit or bit bug? Bit bug? Okay, you guys know more than me. Okay? By the way, even if you get now buy like a million bit bug and put them in a bed. One person can be bit, the another one will not be bit. Some people even get poison. Some people get body reaction. Some people even get body shock. Some people, the body swollen. Some people even go to paralyzation. Somebody's body swollen. Somebody's body get red. What is the message? The sign of Allah will reach with reach. Who is written to whom what? In the hand of Allah. What time now? And what time we're supposed to finish? 4:30, subhanAllah. Every time I call you, the time is keep expanding. Any question, any concern about what's going on? Surah Al-A'raf, chapter 7, verse 26, 32, 58, 126, 133, 174. Look at this ending now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we give them the sign. Maybe they will remember. Maybe to those who know. And this knowledge and this sign to those who are thanking me. And we send it as severe torture. And maybe they come back. Maybe they come back. And also the sign of Allah can be torture, can be to finish people, individual or collective. Any question? Any question, any concern? Any concern? Remember, beg Allah to make you among dhakirin, among musabbihin, among shakirin, among ya'qilun, intellect. And if you want to comprehend that, you go to Surah Al-Imran. Verse 118 and 190. And 190 is the one, the sign of Allah to ulul albab, the people who have the core of intellect. Give me a few minutes. I have to do something in just a few minutes. Do zikr and tasbih. I come back to you. Just a few minutes.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Yes, Sister Aisha. We are all customer. When you talk, make it loud and clear. I hear you like whisper. How are you, Sister Aisha, by the way? Okay, I cannot hear you. Make the phone, microphone straight close to your mouth. Not yet. Straight close to your mouth. Is the room shaking? Okay, let the microphone straight to your mouth, straight, and very close, almost touching your lips. Now I can hear you. In your heart, which one we should worry about, the outside hurricane or the inside hurricane? Exactly. Can I be a mu'min and I call myself a mu'min and my heart is not stable? Or I have a storm once in a while? This is the one. Because if my heart is stable, I don't care about outside. Almost 35,000 companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they died in Palestine and Jordan area by one disease. So one disease take them. Can they stop it? Go study. Can they blame anybody? No. Cannot be done. When the Qadr arrives, the Qadr arrives. We cannot change anything. If you remember all the talk about Qadr, it makes you calm, really calm. Because if you remember, what is the main concepts about believing in Allah's Qadr? خيره وشره, the good and bad. And we're going to have a combination. And this combination, we do not know when. We will never know when. We do not have a list. Today, I get a good qadr. Tomorrow, I get a bad qadr. Today, I get a good qadr. Tomorrow, we do not have a list. But how I prepare myself? Iman. If I have iman, something happened good to me, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, and I use it for Allah. And if something happened I do not like, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, allahumma ajurni fi musibati wa akhlif li khayran minha, and I believe without no doubt, nothing can happen without a wisdom and goodness from Allah to me. And at this time, everything will be good. Please be careful. We hear the message, but once the storm arrives, ask yourself, is my iman still alive? Is me living the message? Or all of a sudden I dropped and I follow culture or my mind? Why Talut and Jalut? Why the army will facing a huge army and take a sip of water? Why? A challenge. Why the mother of Musa? Allah tell her, if you're scared, feed him, throw him in the sea. You remember? Why Maryam alayhi salam, the food was been lifted. Why you get a flu? Why are you losing your teeth? Why you have cavity? Why you have some of your hair get white? Oh, huh? Why are you getting older? You should not get older. Stop it. Don't get older. Can you do that? Until now, we do not know the qadr of Allah. Wallahi, we do not know. Look at every day. Tell me which day you accomplish what you want. And even if we accomplish what we want, do we know which deed is accepted, which one is not? Which deed will elevate us, which deed will decrease us? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said us. Any question, any concern, open my mind. Open my heart. I have a lot to say, but it's not how much I say. Each one of you reflect. After the hurricane, you see you have Hajj. After Hajj and Eid, you have the hurricane. Meaning, you have the reminder about sacrificing, and after that, Allah tell you, you might have no chance. This is a message. Believe me, lately I'm living like I do not know how many days left, how many hours left. And people who see me, they said, what are you thinking about? Sometimes I cannot talk. I cannot talk. And if I said the truth, people sometimes do not believe me. Oh, you're thinking about somebody else. Oh, you're thinking about. Believe me, the only thing bothering me, wallahi, is responsibility. Because when I think about my life, Allahu Akbar, I'm not ready. I really am not ready. Did I did the utmost? No. Did I beg Allah day and night? No. Did I cry to Allah day and night? No. Did I lose weight for sabilillah? No, I'm gaining weight. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. You see? And when I think about the duty and responsibility to all the people around me, to the message of Allah, I'm bankrupt. I do not have too much to show off for. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And when I finished all this, I did like the people of the cave. You know, the three people who went to the cave, and the rock is dropped, and they beg Allah with any sincere good deed. And now I'm talking between you and Allah. I said, Allah, please, if I ever did a good deed to please you, sincere to you, save me, Allah. Save me and give me your rahmah. And deal with me with your af. And deal with me with your generosity. And forgive my bad manner, my lack of iman, my lack of taqwa, my lack of effort. And I beg him. I beg him. And this is what he wants. He wants us to beg him all the time. But after we beg him, what we do? We try. And how you try? At least every day ask Allah, oh Allah, make this day witness to me, not against me. Think how I can gain today. How this day can be a treasure for me. Wallahi, people, this is what makes me sick. When I see people get the message and do not think about it, day after day, and it's gone. And this is da'wah. People do not understand da'wah. Da'wah, you cannot give da'wah until you have da'wah. You have it. And how you have it? Ask yourself, did I gain today? Did I get my palace today? Did I become the queen of my palace today? Did I please Allah today? Did I sacrifice something today? Did I elevate my soul today? Did I develop good manner today? Did I did something against my nafs today? Today, I'm not telling you about yesterday. I'm not telling you about tomorrow. Because if you lose today, you lose tomorrow. If you gain today, you gain tomorrow. And all is what? Heart. Heart. You can be sitting doing nothing and you're gaining a lot with the real devotion in your heart. And if you mean well, as soon or later, Allah will open for you. But if you see Allah is not open for you, something wrong with you. Something wrong with your heart. Make an effort. And when you go to the doctor and the doctor gives you the medication and the recipe, follow it. Imagine I go to the doctor prescribes the medication for me. Now I go to a bookstore, I get white out, and I write some of the medication. I'm cheating the pharmacy. And now the pharmacist gives me the medication minus one or two. Now I believe the doctor. And I'm the one white out the what? Some of the medication of the prescription. This is what we do to ourselves. Yeah? And sometimes we do not go to the doctor at all. And sometimes we don't go to the pharmacist at all. And everything according to our desire. No principle. Come on. I need some question. I need some concern. I need some reflection. Allah choose you to be here now. Allah choose you to hear this. If you want, I can give you 300 verses in Quran about ayat. Imagine over 300. But all of them the same. What I give you is a summary from the all the meaning. Repeat it over and over again with different perspective, but the main concept is the same. Why? Why Allah Jalla Jalalu emphasized this topic? Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He wants to check us our iman and give us a chance and generate hujjah against those who deny. Did you not see my sign? I send you my sign. And what you did with it? You ignore it. Today I ignore you. Stop. Allah al-Azim. If you believe in Allah and the Day of Judgment and meeting your Lord, you can see the sign. Yeah. Hello? Sister Aisha's sister, is the first time she come here? Oh, is it your mother? MashaAllah. Is the first time? MashaAllah. And she come willingly or you push her? MashaAllah. Not to see me. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Alhamdulillah. Don't forget what you're doing is so beautiful. Just to be in this gathering with the right intention and just make her to verify her intention, she will never be lost. Never. 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 You remember in the end of the halaqah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam promised, we get up and the angel surrounding us and descended the sakina and tumaknina and the rahmah of Allah. And in the end, Allah will call, get up, Allah forgive your sins. Imagine how Allah is so rahim. You're coming in the gathering for sabilillah, Allah tell you, get up, I forgive your sins. You eat, and after you eat, you said, Alhamdulillah, alladhi at'amani hadha, warzaqanayhi min ghayra hawlan minni wa la quwwa, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbih. All your bad deed previously is erased. But how many of us still make dua? If you said inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un in a time of any calamity or hardship or whatever happened, and you return it to Allah, and you thank Allah, and you believe is a qadr of Allah, and you believe it is the best for you, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised? أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّنْ رَبِّهِمْ Allah will make salah over you. وَرَحْمَةٌ And mercy. وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ And those are the guided one. How many of us, when the qadr of Allah we do not like, we do that? Not helicopter. Today I was walking in the kitchen, I hit my toes to something, it cut. Can I said, oh garbage can, why you do this to me? Shh, I smack you. Can I smack the garbage can? And even if I smack the garbage can I blame the garbage can? And believe it or not, I discover I am the one who tilted the angle. By this way, the things it hit my finger or it hit my toes, I am the one who caused it. I am the one who caused it. By this way, when the qadr coming, I can do the things to cause the qadr, just because the qadr will take place. How many women marry and said, I do not want kids? Oh, she get a kid. And how many people said, I'm married to get a kid, and they never get a kid? It's not up to our will. How many people marry and they think they will be happy, and they will not get happy? Happiness, goodness in the hand of Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. Huh? What happened today? Everybody drinking bamburi before they come? La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Alaykum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. How are you, Sister Thamina? Tell me, what is new? Okay. Yes. That's it. And it has to be sacrificed. A lot of us, we do not get it. We do not get it. Who know what you have and do not have? Who know your ability? Okay, who know if you sacrifice or no? If you struggle or no? And a lot of people do not get it until now. You will never able to sacrifice and struggle outside unless you win inside. Inside is the one. Inside is the one. If you do not win inside, you will never win outside. You have to win inside. How you win outside? Again, dhikrullah, thanking Allah, tasbih. But a lot of people do not go not understand tasbih until now. Tasbih, when you realize the glory of Allah above anything. Again, how I can do tasbih and still stuck in my own thinking? Something wrong with my tasbih. Because if you said subhanallah with the right meaning, this life is diminished. Diminished. Do you remember one of Allah's name? Huwa al-warith wa huwa al-baqi. What meaning al-warith? The inheritor. Al-baqi, the one is staying. Nobody's staying. He decided already. and nobody inherit anything. No, he's the one inherit the earth وَمَنْ عَلَيْهَا and everything between and over above. What about me and you? إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. We belong to Allah and we are returning to Allah with our baggage. Okay. ما شاء الله. Okay, I was telling many people last couple of days because everybody coming with the same thing. Don't ever forget what I'm going to say is a constitution of the pious people in the early days. If somebody tell you something and you get upset, now you have to ask yourself, did I upset because what he tell me is true or what he tell me is wrong? If you are a Muslim, you can get the answer. If you're Indian, you'll never get the answer. What it meaning? If my emotion is just emotion, or a woman emotion, or Indian emotion, I will not get the answer. But if I'm a Muslim, I will know the answer. If I give you a sentence or a word and it hurt your feeling, and you get upset, ask yourself, is me upset why? Because I'm right or I'm wrong? If I'm wrong, make dua for me, you should not get upset. And if I'm right, you should not get upset. You should be very happy. At least I give you the right advice and you correct yourself. But our ego and our arrogance and our stubbornness will not allow us. You understand me? Think for a moment. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته سيدي رشيد. Say it again. And you see, we have a sickness today. If this happened in America, everybody think about it. But every day it happened in Latin America, it happened in Philippines, it happened in Thailand, it happened in Bangladesh, it happened in South India. Nobody talk about it. But as we are moving according to the, not internet, according to the news in the media. The news in the media affecting us. Because if you study psychology, the things you see all the time, and you hear all the time, it affects you. And this is why they repeat, repeat, repeat. But for example, about New York, you get affected and you think about it. But it's a hurricane last couple of weeks in South Korea, in Japan, in China, in Philippines, and many, many people was flooded. Many million people affected. Many people is sick. What about the people in Burma? What about all the calamity in Syria? All of a sudden we forget. Why? Because we not focus. And we allow the environment to affect us. If we allow the environment to affect us, something wrong with our iman. We not focus. Because I should return it again. The same day, or the same couple of days, the same hurricane, it hit Cuba. It hit Venezuela. It hit many areas in Latin America. Many people died. Many people get affected and more poor and more needy. Anybody talk about them? No. Because the damage is done is so huge, but the message is 20, 30 seconds. You forget. But the message about America, daily, 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 daily. You get it or no? And this is why you have to remember Allah all the time. If you don't remember Allah and try to remember and think about Akhirah, you're finished. You're finished. Dunya will get you. Dunya will get you. It's not easy. It's not easy. Because today you're hearing me for 1 hour. After that you go, okay, for 51 hour or 50 hour a week. 50 hour, 24 hour time 7. How many? 24 hour times 7. 2 times 7 is 140. 148. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Make a decision. Okay, 4 times 7 is what? 28. 28 plus 140 is 168. By the way, 168 hour a week. Minus 2 hour from Brother Ahmed is 160. Six. By the way, 166. How many hour for Sabilillah? How many hour I think about Akhirah? And how many hour of dunya? And also, how many hour of dunya my heart drink it. Drink it. Today you leave Brother Ahmed, you're sitting someplace. And all of a sudden you think about them. What happened to the halaq? It's gone. This meaning disease of the heart. Meaning the message of Allah is not reaching. And the message of dunya is reaching. The message of Allah is not making big impact. The message of dunya is making big impact. Why? The disease is rooted. By this way, when you water the tree of dunya, it's ready to grow. It's ready. And when you water the tree of iman, it's so small. It needs a lot, but we not water it enough. Do you understand now or no? Any reflection? Yeah, Sister Nur al-Huda, you used to coming with all question and all this. What happened? Alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. What mean nothing? If nothing happened, is a problem. Okay, loud, I cannot hear you. Wait, what's going on? Everybody, literally, somebody tell me something, it hurt me. What's going on? You know, yesterday I was with Singaporean groups from Singapore. Everybody the same topic. What happened if somebody hurt me and somebody's sensitive and he said this? Yeah, wallahi, this week, everybody the same. And we think we are sensitive. We're not sensitive, we are arrogant. If you are sensitive, meaning you are sensible. And if you are sensitive, meaning you are considerate, you are kind, you are forgiving, is a quality. But today, when I get arrogant, I call it sensitive. No. Meaning I'm not ready to receive the truth, or I'm not ready even for somebody to call me names. Are you better than Aisha radiallahu anha? I was reminding people with that. Imagine Aisha radiallahu anha, Rasulullah sallam came, he would not talk to her. And he said, go to your father's family. And he didn't talk. And he would not talk to her, salamu alaykum, and that's it. And her father and mother, they refused to talk to her. Nobody talked to her. And she's what, 15, 16 years old? Maybe maximum 17? Is actually younger than that. Okay? And later on, close to 30 days, when one of the maid tell her, and she made a mistake, she said, oh, I don't like the people when they talk bad about people. She said, what are you talking about? She said, you do not know. People talking, the whole Medina talk about you. She said, what are you talking about? She was thinking she's joking. And all this time, Aisha radiallahu anha, she doesn't know what's going on. The whole Medina gossip about her, and she doesn't know. And when the maid tell her, this is your teacher wife, the one Rasulullah asked us to imitate them. When she heard the news about the rumor about her, what she said? Did she blame? Did she complain? Did she get moody? Did she get upset? Did she did Indian movie? No. You know what she said? Look at this girl and her iman and see if you can imitate her. She said, oh Allah, she raised her hand to Allah and she said, you know, I am bari'ah. I am pure from what they say. You purify me, Allah. That's it. And she have conviction, Allah will purify her. What kind of iman is that? Tell me, what iman is that? Immediately she returned it to Allah. Did she make Indian movie against her father and mother? Did she make Indian movie against her husband? And she get hurt. But she believe Allah will purify her. By this we return it to Allah Jalla Jalal. Is it not the message? Now, if somebody again upset you or hurt your feeling, what it mean hurt your feeling? If I insult you and I hurt your feeling, if I insult you, meaning I'm wrong, you should then make me dua for me and make me, you should be very happy and give me some gift because I give you a lot of reward. And if what I said is true, you should reflect and correct your mistake. Finished. Did we reach this level? Not yet, or not yet? Huh? Ya Noor, whatever, Huda. Hello? Okay, now, let me tell you something. You're supposed to be a woman and a man in the meantime. Which one is powerful? To humble yourself and say the truth? That's it. And it's very simple, especially if the goal is high. You know what's the goal? We have many goals, but we forget it. Number one, your heart to be free, to be clean. So when you put your head in the pillow, you not go to a drama. And she tell me, and I tell her, and why she tell me, and why I tell her, and do, hey, oh. You not want to do that. It's not worth it. We have something higher to be busy about it. It's the message, it's the journey of Iman, above all this movie. Second, ask yourself, is this happen with Rahim, meaning people of the family, or for Sabilillah, or somebody unknown? If somebody unknown, don't worry about it, make dua for them, finished. And if the people of Rahim, meaning people of the family, ask yourself, if the family member did something against me, okay, I forgive them for Sabilillah. And I get a lot of reward. And I make dua for them. Read the chapter of Af. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he promised, whoever do Af and forgive in a time he can deliver, Allah bring him in the day of judgment and make him marry from the Hur al-Ain anyone he wants. Nothing is many a hadith about this topic. Or go to the chapter of Af. And whoever do Afu and Maghfirah first, Rasulullah he said, nothing you can meet Allah with better than that. You remember the man who went to his son in the day of judgment, and he said, my son, I have 49 good deed and I have 51 bad deed and I'm not able to go to Jannah. Do you have one good deed for me? You can give it to me. The son replied, he said, my father, I love you, always good to me. And I have only one good deed. Only one good deed I have it in my whole life. And I'm going to Jahannam anyway. Take my good deed and enjoy Jannah. It's better for you. Take it, my father. Now the father go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the extra good deed. And Allah ask him, bring your son. He bring his son. He asks the son, why you give your father one good deed? He said, ya Allah, I know one good deed will not do nothing to me. I cannot make it. I'm going to Jahannam anyway. And I prefer to give it to my father better than me. You know what Allah replied? He said, you try to be generous? He said, yes, ya Allah, at least to my father. He said, I am the owner of generosity. Take the hand of your father and go with both of you to Jannah. I forgive both of you. What happened if you live this message? In the day of judgment, you can meet Allah and Allah will tell you, remember the day so-and-so, you forgive so-and-so and you give afwa to so-and-so? You said, yes, ya Allah. He said, I forgive you today. One of the most beautiful quality, it can elevate you so high to humble yourself and forgive each other and have a pure heart inside. Whoa! This is the ultimate treasure you can meet Allah with. You remember Umar ibn Abdul Aziz when somebody insult him in the market. What he did? Somebody came to him and said, so and so insult you. He said, is shaitan do not find somebody better than you? Or else than you? And he put his hand in his pocket. And whatever money he has, he said, go and buy sweet and give it to the man who insulting me. He said, why? He said, this is the minimum I can do for all the good deed he give me. Huh? Do you want to lose good deed or you want to gain good deed? Because sometimes, if you have a bad feeling even about somebody and it's not true, you can lose your good deed to another person. And if you ask me, it's very easy to get emotion over one word or something insignificant, and we can lose each other. We can lose our relationship. We can lose our iman. We can lose our good deed. If now my iman is high, my da'wah to Allah is high, my quality between me and Allah is high, what's the big deal? What's the big deal? Elevate yourself. You can elevate yourself. How? You elevate yourself by being forgiven and forgiver. What will happen? Allah will forgive you. Oh, are you an angel? Hello? Are you Maryam alayhi salam? Are you Maryam alayhi salam? Okay. Are you better than Aisha radiallahu anha? Okay. You know what's happened? If you look at our faces when we uptight, Allahu Akbar, like somebody smack us. And once we release, what happened? We become ease. We become ease. Ease to deal with, ease to handle, ease to receive, ease to give. This ease, billahi, is so high than anything in this life. Go quick, wallahi. People, go quick. Forgive each other. Open your heart. Let it go. Because what happened today when you ask me, all the topic even we get upset about it is not an issue. Is not an issue. Is shayateen attack. What do we do? Is almost be open account with shaitan? Astaghfirullah. Close the account. You can close the account right away. and get your money back. Get your good deed back from shaitan. You deserve it. What do you think? Hello? Because you want again your beautiful smile come, your open heart come. Okay? You want your iman to be alive. You want to be busy with goodness. Wake up big time. You do not want hurricane inside. You don't want it. You don't want a small hurricane or a tropical storm. You don't want it. Now it's 4:30. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open for all of us and give us and fill our heart with iman. Fill our heart with love of Allah. Fill our heart with the journey of iman. Fill our heart with tawakkul ala Allah. Fill our heart with thiqa of Allah. Fill our heart to be the people of forgiver, the people of af, people of safh, people of love each other. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who are awake and alert about the sign of Allah, and the one who able to see and comprehend the sign of Allah and benefit from the sign of Allah and make the sign of Allah witness to us, not against us, ya Allah. And make us among those who is a cause to wake up the people, not among the people of ghafileen. Oh Allah, I'm weak, I'm a sinner, I do not have the quality, and you are the owner of quality, Allah. Decorate me with quality of your quality. Decorate me of quality of your quality. And fill me, Allah, with quality of your quality. And give me strength against myself, strength against my shayateen, and purify my heart from all the diseases of the heart, and fill our heart with nur, and tranquility and peace, and tumanina, ya Allah. Make our your angel, ya Allah, is the protection of us from all the shayateen. And oh Allah, make this dunya witness to us, not against us. And make us the cause to lead us to Jannah, insha'Allah, not to Jahannam, ya Allah. Oh Allah, we are weak and you are strong. And you are the owner of the quality. And we are weak and sinner. And our nafs is weak and sinner. Oh Allah, we need you, ya Allah. We need you, Allah. Protect us, ya Allah. Give us the hope and strength to be belong to you, ya Allah. Oh Allah, oh Allah, you allow us to hear. Meaning you still love us. You give us a chance, ya Allah. Oh Allah, don't deny us, ya Allah. Make us always knock the door of your rahmah, Allah. And make us enter to the door of rahmah, Allah. And with all our negligence and weakness and sins, oh Allah, I still have hope. You are so arham al-rahameen. Accept me, Allah, to make us among those who will be accepted by you. And give me strength against my weakness, strength against my shayateen. Give me victory, Allah. Give me elevation, ya Allah. Give me quality, Allah. Oh Allah. Oh Allah, I do not believe in nobody except you. I do not believe in nobody can give me anything except you. And nobody can benefit me without your will. And nobody can harm me without your knowledge and ability, Allah. Oh Allah, oh Allah, oh Allah. I believe in you by your rahmah, Allah. You choose me to be a human being. You choose me to be a Muslim. You choose me to hear all this knowledge. You allow me to comprehend it. But I do not have the strength. Give me strength, ya Allah. Give me ability, ya Allah. Give me for you. Make me for you, by you, toward you, ya Allah. Help me, Allah. Support me, Allah. Support me, Allah, until I meet you. I meet you with your pleasure. And I see your beautiful face, ya Allah. And make me the key of goodness, the lack of evil, ya Allah. And make me busy for you, by you, toward you, ya Allah. Ameen. Ameen, ya Rabbil Alameen. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد على آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين O Allah, make us among those who ذاكرين والذاكرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والقانتين والقانتات يا الله يا الله ارزقنا الإخلاص في السر والعلانية ارزقنا البركة والنور والقبول فيما نفعل وفيما نقول واجعلنا من المسبحين واجعلنا من المستغفرين، واجعلنا من التوابين، واجعلنا من أهل الهدى والرضا واليقين، واجعلنا من أهل الفلاح، ومن أهل الكرامة، ومن أهل العزة، ومن أهل التمكين، ومن أهل النصرة، يا ربنا، يا إلهنا، يا قريب، يا مجيب، يا سلام، يا أكرم الأكرمين، ويا أرحم الراحمين، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، يا أول، يا آخر، يا ظاهر، يا باطن، وأنت بكل شيء عليم. يا الله، يا الله، تقبل منا، إنك أنت السميع العليم، وتب علينا يا مولانا، إنك أنت أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أوزعنا أن نشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علينا وعلى والدينا، وأن نعمل صالحا ترضاه، وأدخلنا برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين. ربي، إلهي، مولاي، اللهم لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا، وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة، إنك أنت الوهاب. اللهم إنك جامع الناس ليوم لا ريب فيه، فاجمعنا مع نبيك وحبيبك مصطفاك، وأنت راض عنا وتقبل منا يا رب العالمين. وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. جزاكم الله كل خير، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.